Mike is live. Hello.
Yeah, Twitch is definitely not open, but looks like the actual stream.
Yeah, it's running weird because my computer was not on.
I think your computer is just washed.
I closed the register. I closed Discord. I closed.
Right. Does somebody have their different?
Game one. Clackenside versus Retrobot. Yeah. Fox is very good against Rob, at least compared to Little Match, but Shane is very, very good at the Fox matchup. And I think Shane would rather stick with his original main in this scenario.
What?
I'm surprised this computer is... Okay. Nice little spot dodge for you, charging that smash for a little bit longer to wait for those ice lines to go away. Yeah, I'm liking the Hell's Power Steel and these projectiles a lot. And I also like utilization of the Smash Attack to power through the obstacles. Because he takes damage, but he doesn't get knocked back or anything, so it's actually not a bad idea. And it's something that Quinn can try using more in the matchup. And he has KO Punch, so, well, but nice gyro by Retrobot to get rid of it. Yeah, that's an easy punish. Yeah, good stuff by Quinn to get that up smash. He's sitting pretty comfortably. I mean, Retrobot can do down throw up air though. I don't know if that would kill now. But otherwise, he still has a decent lead that he can definitely extend to a very hard to catch up one. And yeah, so far, he's doing a good job. Gets a really good up smash, powering through that obstacle. And now sitting very comfortably, but gets a down throw, will get the up air, gets the air dodge lead. Smash 4-101 right there. Fucking read the air dodge. That's how you get all your stocks. That's pretty tough to edge guard actually, because his up air just kind of goes through the ledge and you can't really do anything about it. You have to shield and wait for it to end, then you can probably drop down. So yeah, Retrobot making this comeback very real right now. It has a lot of momentum. Quinn trying to regain his footing here. Good power shield coming in, but oh, this is one gets punished. Doesn't get punished too hard, but Retrobot now willing to use the platform to charge his gyro and kind of lay back a little bit. Ooh, that was very scary. If he got hit, that would have been it. Oh, looking for a roll there, but Shane not biting quite yet. And that gyro hitting him. Good F tilt. The gyro is now down. It's still technically in Retrobot's possession, though, but it goes away. KO Punch is live, though. This is very scary. Retrobot can do the best he can to keep him away. Ooh, gets the KO Punch, and that's it. Game one going to Quinn. There is the team. Alright, so where's Retrobot gonna take him? I believe I heard Quinn say he bans Triplat. I can see him going to FD. That's a good place. Town City, they could run it back there, because today benefits highly from the low ceiling. That's where they're going.
Yeah. We're gonna Quinn and Brady. Brady, we need you to go up now. We're gonna start some matches in the second pool so we can try and get ahead.
Alright, the double dash attack by Quinn, bringing him off skill. Retrobot has to be a little bit careful with these falling nairs. Rob's nair is just weird and hard to deal with, but if you know how to deal with it, it's actually pretty unsafe on steel, despite having pretty low running out otherwise. And I love the jab at cancel the up by Quinn. Quinn is playing very well right now. He's looking for a footstool setup right there. If you can get a footstool off nair, he just tried it again. Rob being a big body, it's pretty easy to get on. But right now, Retrobot being kind of overwhelmed here. Quinn has all the momentum in the world, all the stage control. Ooh. Kind of loses it though. Now it's Retrobot regaining his footing here. He's able to get the grab. Nice air dodge read. And all of a sudden, Shane has all the momentum now. I don't know what that was. Oh my goodness. After starting off so well, unable to do any more percent, and then Shane able to just end his stock. So good turnaround from Shane. Oh, but he gets that smash. Yeah, that nair was a bit stuck. Oh, was that a twisty? With the gyro? I don't even know fucking enough. Alright, good stuff by Shane. Now he's good roll read, yeah. Very, very good stuff from Shane here. And Yeah. Oh, that is so scary. But yeah, good roll away from Shane, just at the right time. The action of footstool by Shane, I like it. Oh no, this is where it gets scary, because KO Punch will for sure kill. And down tilt into it might even do it. So he has to be super careful. But if he gets even one projectile, he gets hit by it, it's all good. But he misses, so there goes his chance of getting a KO Punch, at least for now. Nice gyro in there, I like it. Shane very good at those gyro setups and combos. Oh, I see what he tried to do there. He tried to get the gyro to hit with the up throw, but just kind of... this wasn't at the right position to get it to work. And now he's going to be looking for this kill. He gets a good scale now, but gets the up air, and that'll take it. Good stuff by Shane. After Quinn, like, on a very good start, Shane was able to just suppress that momentum and convert it into a W for himself. So good stuff.
Boy.
Good. Yo, I'm dropping a mixtape.
I'm dropping a mixtape?
Oh, I want to, at least.
I don't know how, dude.
How the fuck do you do that? I don't know how to, like, compile all this stuff together and do it. I don't know how to do that.
But first off, you need to get the bars.
No, that's true.
Then you get to go to Dat Piff, upload, and then watch all the ladies swarm.
Watch all the, like, two fans in the world who come to get it.
Hey, those two fans will be the most loyal fans you'll ever have in your life.
That is true. It's best of three, five.
This is pool, so it's gonna be best of three.
Okay. Oh, wow. The last hit up there seemed to hit him out. And yeah, now, Queen going Fox. I just... now that was that. And yeah, Shane's good at the Fox matchup, but Fox excels on tri-plats like this. You can get up air repeatedly like Cloud.
Overall, which is definitely a matchup in favor for Fox.
Yeah.
But you know Shane is...
yeah. I guess the air dodge move just kind of misses other times. And yeah, when you're off stage against Rob, especially Shane's Rob as Fox, it's very scary because he just kind of knows exactly what to do. See, like, right there, I mean, he covers so many options.
That is what Shane excels at. He just knows the setup.
And it's good timing, too, because Rob's down air has a lot of startup, and he's still able to get that perfectly in his first try. But he just has that timing down, and he knew when Quinn was going to go through it. Oh my god, that was so close. Yeah, that shine spike attempt, if you even call it that.
Yeah, it seems like almost he's trying to fish for it a little bit.
Yeah, it's something, he's like the only Fox I know that actually goes for, and he has gotten it multiple times somehow, so I mean,
he's a good backer right there.
But on Rob specifically, I don't know if it's really worth, because he just has really, really, like, almost infinite recovery. I guess he misses tech, but then, wow, that's unfortunate.
That's unfortunate to watch, another SD.
So Shane, after losing game one, gets JV2 in game three to take the set.
No, it's gotta be disappointing for Quack Attack. Well, Shane continues to steamroll through the bracket.
Is he 2-0? What is he?
What was the count?
Man, so far I think he's
2-1. Kyle and Ricky on the screen.
That's great.
Alright. So we got Miller, Ricky, who was just on the mic with me, versus Fjord. Fjord, obviously, Korn representative out of, like, the 10 we already got here. Ricky has ZSS and Cheek and Mario. He has a bunch of characters. I don't know who he's going to pull out specifically, but I guess we'll see. I haven't seen him play forever. I haven't even seen him in forever. But yeah, Fjord, a VT regular. Hello, Quinn.
Hey, man.
How do you feel about your set against Shane just now?
I thought it was all right. I think I messed up at the end.
Yeah, that was unfortunate.
But it happens.
Shane is very good at the matchup.
Yeah.
Fox matchup.
Oh, yeah. I think he's pretty good at
I think that's probably his most comfortable character to play against, honestly.
Really?
I just said something like that, mm-hmm. I think. Yeah. I don't know if he... Well, no, he should just move it on, but...
I wouldn't be surprised. He's really good. I wish I didn't miss the ledge, but... It happens.
It was just a weird ending, because, like, you dared him, he missed his tech, and then he died. And then
I died.
I was distracted by that, so I didn't even see how...
I didn't see the ledge either. No. I was, like... super close to the ledge, but not enough to magnet me in. But
it happens as a magnet hand can come through.
Yeah, not this time.
I
had a piece of carbon. I haven't been here in a long time, but it's cool. Yeah, I don't know how far. Oh man, this team's about is behind by about a seven, which is like typical. He's gonna go Mario. Okay, I actually like the Mario pick because Mario is a very good combo character, and Corrin being like such a like good weight.
Ooh, hold on, get batteries running.
Batteries are
plugged in.
Make sure
it's plugged in home.
That's the charger.
Isn't there a way we can? Oh,
it's not plugged in here.
Oh no!
I got it.
Nice. All right, let's hope that's good. I don't know if there's supposed to be like an icon we can look at, but
let's see.
We don't want the stream to drop again.
Yeah, there it is.
Okay,
that's
cool.
What it looks like. This charger. I don't know if you have like Windows, but I think it's like. But yeah, I like the Mario choice for game one. Mario can combo Corrin very heavily.
Mm-hmm.
And Corrin is just one of the easier characters in the game to combo. But Corrin herself has a good juggler game.
Yeah.
Especially with like her Nair and up there.
Doesn't Mario just naturally like kind of quote unquote lose to sort of ease?
In general, yeah, they can all just kind of space him out. But yeah, Mario excels when he gets in.
Yeah.
And
if you let him
so
in.
So far, yeah.
If you let him in.
So far,
real good.
Miller's done a good job of getting those bread and butter Mario combos in. So Fjord has to adjust that. Make sure not to let him in. Space with fairs more. He does have to be careful with the Dragon Fang shot because he can tape it.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something he has to remember. Oh, wow. Ooh, good Nair, actually. I'm surprised he had time to get that out. But see, yeah, he got down throwed at like 90 and he was still able to get an up there follow up. So, you know, a lot of things that Ricky can do to kind of use that high percent. Yeah. Nice pin and guaranteed damage. Oh my gosh, he's able to avoid the pin,
wow.
Does neutral get up and has time to do a back.
Oh, and the snipe? Nope, not quite.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a nice movement from Mario.
Yeah, good spot dodge and follows up with the Nair.
I respect that, trying to spike him.
Yeah.
Or trying to snipe him, I bet, with the fireball.
Yeah, Ricky going for a hard read, but you're actually getting around it.
Oh,
really,
nice
really
pivot
good.
Grab.
Yeah.
Ooh, stale.
It is a bit stale, yeah, he used it a couple moves ago. But one more at the ledge would probably do it. And that's punishable. Ooh.
No, it's not. Well, I mean, I guess it's just a little bit sooner. But.
Yeah, good DI by Miller. I thought that would have killed, actually, but it was.
Neither player seems to own it, like, just as I say it, right?
Yeah, just one missed space there by Miller able to get the back throw punish.
Yep.
Finally killing at 150.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice pin, man.
Yeah,
got a tip.
Oh, nice. It must have been, yeah, I don't see how it was going to interesting. Corrin's pin tip razor. That was really nice. That perfect.
Yeah, these so pivot down tilts are really looking like Little Mac over here a little bit.
I really like
nice combo.
Perfect. His pivot grabs.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
His pivot grabs are pretty solid. Yeah.
And that's kind of
really good.
Yeah.
Oh, nice follow up.
But yeah, very even game. No one's really dominated one each other at all in this game. Yeah, I like Fjord trying to get tricky with that back there. Nice read, by the way. He bared so that he could cover, like, maybe a roll, and then he could punish because the bear would ping in the back.
Mm-hmm.
But it didn't work. You can get pretty tricky with Corrin's bear. And looking for an air dodge there, but it didn't work. Oh, no. Okay, I thought he fell too low.
Oh,
nice
ledge jump
bear.
Let's go. Oh, water not gonna do it.
Oh,
nice
my God.
Tech
that
off
tech was
bear. Alright, now we got Mario, a little bit of mid-range high percent.
Yeah.
We got a rage coin.
Oh no. Yeah, caught DIing away, and that nearly killed even at 70.
Yeah.
Good wait by Shiro to get that bear.
Not gonna quit quite. Yeah, let's see if she can make it. Nope.
Yeah, pin is very, very.
Ooh, my goodness, just barely. Ooh, the bite catches it.
Yeah, the up smash, like, clanged with the actual plasma, but
oh, yeah.
the hitbox after it was. So very, very close to being down to the wall. I think that smash throw platform, when Ricky had the flood that nearly gimped, it could have worked, but the smash throw platform was there to save him. So I think that was a pretty pivotal moment in that game. I feel like if that wasn't there, I'd feel a little bad.
How's it feel playing against a good fox?
Oh, good Nair.
Shut up.
time. Mario's Nair is a good combo breaker. I don't know if it's the same like speed as Luigi's.
Oh my god, he ran all the way. Oh, I thought he was gonna get that grab. He can get to that grab so hard.
Oh,
yeah,
Ricky?
Yeah, he just ran and ran.
Yeah, he gets that a lot. Very good at it. I'm looking for air dodge, but sure, do a good job of not biting. Yeah, I like Fjord's pin usage, especially with Ricky like on the ledge. He's kind of like walked away. Whenever Ricky either needs to get up or like jumped on, he kind of just faded away with him and then pinned safely. Mm-hmm. It's very good.
Ooh, that's not very scary. The bite. Ooh, but the bite's not coming back enough.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that he didn't get punished.
Another pivot grab, yeah. Fjord was just kind of standing there holding shield, so it was very easy for Ricky to get that grab. And I think he's caught on to that habit. So Fjord might want to do some more mix-ups in that regard, not let that happen again. He's lucky that...
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow.
That
was hard. That Nair, like, just saved him.
Barely, yeah.
He was, like, even a fraction of a second late. That probably would have hit him and died.
I'm really, like, I'm really liking the movement from Mario right now.
Mm-hmm.
And throughout this whole set, you know, just... It just looks really smooth, the way he's back and forth.
It is really good, yes.
If we could just get one more up smash.
Yeah.
That nice.
With the rage he has.
Yeah.
That'll kind of ran into it, yeah.
That'll do too, man.
I think he was confused as to whether he should nair or fall with counter, maybe. I think that's something that happens, and in that mix up, he just got hit.
Oh, there's the cave. I was wondering if he was gonna use it.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Fjord kind of putting himself in a weird position, but coming back with that bear, that's pretty solid.
I like the attempt by Fjord. It actually worked, but it's another running pivot grab, yeah. Ricky's done almost all of those.
I like that. I respect that goal for that T-frame, Mario slide,
yeah.
I like that.
It's very janky. You don't expect it to hit. Yeah. It can kill a hero. Mm-hmm. There's not many people that can react to that.
Mario's clicking down the cyclone to kind of pop him up. And then
you think Rage might have affected that a little bit? I mean, he had like 120.
Yeah, he probably knew more than I did.
Oh, wow.
Up tilt.
Nice.
Oh,
very good damage. He's still going with it. Looking for a roll away. But good nair. He gets the spike. I think he read his double jump and just fared him and he died. JV good
two.
Stuff.
We are in Junior Varsity number 2.
Yeah, after Fjord was able to take that stop out there, Ricky never let him touch him again.
Yeah.
So very good, very, very good way to end that game for Miller. He's going into game 3 with very good momentum.
Yeah.
But he has to play 2 for his counter pick.
Switching characters. I don't think Mario seems to be doing pretty good for him, but I don't know, he's got his EFS and anything from Fjord, sticking to his guns, I respect that.
So yeah, Miller just went to ZSS, and they're going to FD, okay. I think he switched to ZSS because he expected him to go to Battlefield because that's what's going to help him. But like, I feel like ZSS benefits from bypass more than Corwin does.
Really?
Like,
in terms of like up smash,
like up air, up B. Like ZSS is just so deadly. So I think that's what he's doing. Corwin's not bad on SD either. So I can see it.
This is the grab, gets punished for it.
Yeah, I don't know if he could have
done it anymore. Punch that, maybe a grab into something? But
yeah.
Actually, I don't know if Corwin grabs even more. That might have been the best one I could have done. Alright, into the air, let's use it.
See, on Battlefield, that might have been a stock, because he would have had the other platform deal.
Oh,
he gets the down B spike,
ooh.
Sick.
Alright.
And now a very comfortable lead for Miller,
yeah?
Oh, wow.
He's gonna break this in. Making his way up, let's see if, let's see if George can make the comeback. Which is very, very much in the realm of possibilities at this point.
Yeah.
And we just need both players to earn Fjord to play just a little more solid.
Yeah, he's doing the same thing he did with Mario. Running across the stage doing a trigger grab. It's a bit more risky with ZSS because
you get that
if you miss,
you
get that ending life.
Ooh, and the bite coming
and
in.
Fjord's done doing a fantastic job of not taking much percent in this last stock, in this tournament stock.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm liking that. Holding on to,
oh, wow.
Oh my god, it's a very solid B. And I like how he didn't commit to the double up air, because he probably figured it wouldn't kill at this percent, but I think if he does it now, he might do it. Ooh, and I really like that attempt here.
Oh, nice turn.
Okay. Yeah, kind of hanging for a bit too long there, and whenever a Corwin sees that, they're going to go for that pin. It kills very, very early, on the ledge especially. But yeah, you're bringing it all the way back.
Oh, okay. I think he wanted to hit the ground and kind of get a ticket, maybe. But he's about to even it up. I mean, it's pretty much even at this point.
Oh, wow.
So Ricky's just gonna get his footing back.
Ooh. Oh, I love the option coverage there. He was able to avoid the plasma, but then he went with the rising in air.
Oh, yeah. Doing that, running into a pivot grab again. I don't know if that's a good deal. Okay. Man, I'm sure you'll get some good stuff. It's just,
ooh,
that
ending
line is just so nice.
Oh my god.
Pin? Ooh,
oh,
I
someone's
actually
Hey, that was the correct option. He just kind of mistimed it. But yeah, George, you're very good position right now. But remember, the percent that you're at right now.
This is so really close.
Very scary. Because he has that.
Oh man, commits to the ground. Gets punished for it. And good job to Fjord.
Yeah, I don't know if he's yes, that's
Oh, whoops, great.
On
one.
On the off-stream setup. Quinn, you're gonna play Ricky on the on-stream setup. Right now.
Okay. Oh, so you're staying. Alright, well, have fun, guys.
Stay right there.
Whoa. What's up?
We got Clack Attack versus Miller. Miller's staying on screen. And I see he's going for Sheik. Sheik is very good against Lil Mac. I think that's the match. He's just going for the matchup advantage. Because Sheik's needles are extremely good against Mac. And off stage, it's just a pain for Mac in general, but especially against Sheik. It's an absolute pain to make it back. So if Miller plays it right, he can just get Mac extremely early. And with the combos that she has, even with his combos right here, she's very, very good at wrapping up early damage. But Mac also doing the same thing with this tilt.
Right now, the mic a little bit because I don't think anybody can hear you.
What?
Yeah. Let's see if more people can hear it now.
Twitch isn't even on.
Yes, it is. It's streaming.
Oh, I'm washed.
Yes, you are washed.
But where is it? Like Firefox.
I don't have it up. I'm not afraid to overload my computer any more than it is right now. And this is with pretty bad quality because I can't figure out what the issue is. But
you want?
No, it's not the internet at all. It's literally my computer's like, I'm not feeling this today. It was running fine last night too.
This is very scary. Yeah, that'll get.
Wow, that was a quick game.
Pretty quick game from Clack Attack there. Yeah. He was able to just, you know, get all those kill confirms at low percent, kill him with the smash attack, and then with KO punch, down tilt KO punch, that's all it takes, even at like 20. And Sheik being a fast faller, is pretty susceptible to tilts. Yeah, he's gonna switch to Mario. Tried out the Sheik, it didn't quite work, so he's gonna go back to what got him the win last set. Wondering to see where he'd go, Town and City, alright. Yeah, up smash is more threatening on this stage, given the lower ceiling. So it goes both ways because Mac has down tilt up B, and that is also a very scary vertical KO confirm. Oh my goodness, that's. And yeah, good patience by Quinn. Just kind of holding shields, expecting Miller to fall with an aerial, which he did, and gets the punish. And same deal as last game, just kind of getting him to a good percent, using just the super armor on his smash attacks. Very good. Gets the read, but not quite enough, you know. Wasn't close enough to get the follow-up. Yeah. That'll take it. Wow, I thought it was a little bit too low percent, but I guess it was just enough to get that vertical KO. And yeah, KO punch is looming very large here, looking scary. And this is Lil Mac at his best when he's up a stock like this, and he has KO punch. Because stuff like this is just a recipe for a quick game, just like last time. He gets down smash. Oh, wow. That was weird, but able to
able to get rid of KO Punch somehow. It had him off stage, but it gets him back off stage. And he has Flood, so he can use that. But good air dodge by Quinn to avoid that. And he's able to clip him from underneath the stage with the upbeat. So overall, good outcome for Quack Attack more so than Miller. Nice down smash to punish that F smash on shield. Yeah, the up smash was to cover the jump, and he guessed right, but Lil Mac is jumping a little bit too high. Well, that was a very, very risky. Oh, the smash attack, the super armor, yeah. I don't know if he knew that he would do an up smash, he just...